Welcome back to our YouTube channel Playmicrobiology. In this lecture, we will discuss about the biochemical test. We have already made two videos on the identification of bacteria, in which in part one, we have discussed about the proper procedure that are followed in the laboratory for identification of bacteria, and in second lecture, we have discussed about the morphology of bacteria. In this lecture, we will discuss about the biochemical test. Okay, so let's have a quick revision of what we have learned in the previous videos. So there is a sample, okay, that we receive in our laboratory. Then what we will do, we will take out proper culture media according to this sample. For example, if it is a pus, then we will take out meconkey agar or blood agar, inoculate the sample on this petri plate, right? And then after incubation of 24 hours at 37 degrees Celsius, there would be a growth of bacteria. We will find colonies in large amount. Okay, now what we will do, we will mark some proper colonies that we have to that we need to perform further diagnosis, like on which we have to perform further diagnosis. For example, we mark this one, and this one according to the morphology of colony, okay? They must be same. All the colonies that you are marking must be same, okay? So, after marking it, we will take out this colony and take this colony in peptone water, okay? We will inoculate this colony in peptone water and another colony. What we will do, we will take out one slide and prepare a smear from this colony, okay? We can take out this colony with the help of sterile swab, or we can take out this colony with the help of inoculating loop and prepare a proper smear for gram staining. After preparing it and drying it, we will perform gram stain. Okay, now once you are done with gram stain, then you will take this slide under microscope and perform microscopy at 100x lens. Okay, you will use 100x lens, that is oil immersion lens, and identify whether the bacteria we have taken out from the petri plate is gram positive or gram negative. If it is gram positive, then we follow some different biochemical test. If it is gram negative, then there are different biochemical tests for gram negative. Okay, so let's start with gram positive first. For example, the colony you have taken out from this petri plate is gram positive, okay? They are gram positive. Now what you will do, if it is gram positive, then okay, there is no need of this, then we will perform, first we will perform catalase test. Now what is catalase test? In catalase test, what we do, we detect an enzyme that bacteria produces. There are some bacteria that produces catalase test. Sorry, catalase. There are some bacteria that produces enzyme catalase. Now what we will do, we will take hydrogen peroxide on a slide. Okay. For example, one drop of hydrogen peroxide is enough. We will take one drop of hydrogen peroxide on a slide. And we will take one colony. Okay, the colony which we have marked, right? We will pick that one colony with the help of stick, with the help of, you can pick with the help of glass slide, sterile glass slide, okay? Then what we will do, we will place that slide from the corner, like, for example, I pick with the help of this, it is a sterile, suppose it is a sterile stick, and I have put that colony with the help of this marker, and what I will do, I will drop this marker in this H2O2. Now what I will see, I will see some of the bubbles. If I see some of the bubbles, then it is catalase positive. If there is no formation of bubbles, then it is catalase negative. Okay, so what happened? If bacteria produces catalase, then what it will do, this bacteria or this enzyme will break down this H2O2 into H2O plus O, nascent oxygen. Okay, this production of this nascent oxygen causes formation of bubble. Okay, so this is about catalase test. If it is positive, then there would be formation of bubble. If catalase is negative, then there would be no formation of bubble. Okay, this is about H2O2. And one thing more, okay, the thing is, it comes positive for staphylococcus, okay, and it is negative. So for some of the, it is negative for, simply we can say it is negative for streptococcus, okay, some of the species of streptococcus. And the next thing that you have to remind while performing catalase test, that you should never pick colony from blood agar, okay. If you are requested to perform catalase test, then never take colony from blood agar. Always take colony from meconkey or nutrient agar. Nutrient agar is a very good media for performing catalase, but you can also take a colony from meconkey, it is okay, but never take colony from blood agar, because blood agar already contains catalase. If you are taking colony from blood agar, then it may give false result. Okay, so this is one word question, and it is always asked in Viva or practicals. Okay, so this is all about catalase test. Next, we, if for example, now what we will do, it is not like you would not leave, like if catalase is positive, then there is no further diagnosis. No, there is again further diagnosis. There is confirmatory test again. Okay, now if catalase is positive, or if catalase is negative, what we will do? In the second step, if catalase is positive, we will perform coagulase test. And if catalase is negative, then we will perform bile, aesculin, agar test. Okay, if catalase is positive, then you will perform coagulase test, and if it is negative, then you will perform bile, aesculin, agar test. Okay, now we have coagulase test. We will perform coagulase test. There are certain bacterias that produces coagulase enzyme. What does coagulase do? We will take plasma as a reagent. Okay, in the similar way, like we have taken a reagent H2O in case of catalase, in the similar way, in case of coagulase test, we take plasma and test tube. Okay, now what we will do, we will inoculate our colony into this plasma. Okay, colony from petri plate, or we can do instead of colony, it is obviously it is a good thing to take colony always, but instead of a colony, you can also take a swab that is dipped in peptone water. Okay, then you can dip that swab into this plasma. Okay, and this is another way. Okay, so we have plasma, we will put some of our colonies into this plasma, and then what will happen, there would be clotting of this plasma. You know, clotting, what does clotting means? There would be a like whole plasma would convert into a bunch, right? It would not be, it would convert into a solid form rather than liquid. Its original state is liquid, but after inoculating a colony, if bacteria produces coagulase enzyme, then will this plasma would be converted into a clot. Okay, so this happens in coagulase test. Now what is the basic criteria behind this clotting? That is, this coagulase enzyme that is present in bacteria, what this do? It would react with the CRF. Coagulase reacting factor that is present in plasma, it will react with it, and what this will do, it will activate prothrombin prothrombin, right? Now this prothrombin further activates fibrinogen and convert fibrinogen into fibrin. This is the basic logic behind this clotting. Okay, this is all about coagulase test, and it is confirmatory test for staph aureus. Like if it is positive, okay, if there is a formation of clot, then it is confirmed that the bacteria we have taken out from the colony is a staph aureus. Okay, on the other side we have bile, aesculin, agar. Now what does this test do? Bile, aesculin, agar, it contains bile, okay, aesculin, it is aesculin, A-E-S, okay, aesculin and ferric chloride. And there is also other thing like agar, there is also agar, but these three things are important to remember this test procedure, okay. Now what will happen in this test? In bile, aesculin, agar, bacteria, we insert our bacteria into the test tube that contain bile, aesculin, agar, okay. It would be probably slant, okay. Okay, now what we will do, we will streak our colony on this slant. Now incubate it. Now what we will found, this bile will help this bacteria to grow. Okay, bile will help bacteria to grow. 40% bile, okay. 40% bile will help bacteria to grow. Now this growing bacteria would convert this aesculin into aesculatin. Okay, further this aesculatin will react with ferric chloride and form black colored colonies. And this is confirmatory test for streptococcus. Not actually streptococcus. It is confirmatory test for group D streptococcus that are now known as enterococci. Okay. So this is all about gram positive. If you find your bacteria is gram positive, the colony you have picked and stain is gram positive, then first you will perform catalase. If it is positive, then you will perform coagulase test, and if it is negative, then you will perform bile, aesculin, agar. If coagulase confirms, like if coagulase is positive, then there would be a growth of staph aureus. If bile, aesculin, agar is positive, then there would be formation of black colored colonies that indicate the streptococci, enterococci, group D streptococci that are known as enterococci now. Okay, so this is all about gram positive. Now we will discuss about gram negative.